This is the OTB Network.
Welcome to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. I'm Jean Wood. We've just finished a portion of the traditional holiday weekend's worth of action for the 4th of July. Because of the midweek holiday, it's going to be spread out a little bit between last weekend and this weekend. A lot of great racing action, however, just completed. We're going to begin at Delaware Park, where on Saturday afternoon they ran the Denise Rudy for fillies on the turf. Let's head down to Delaware in the running of the Rudy.
And they're off into the Denise Rudy. Between horses, Maria's Golden Rose are lined up across the track with the red Lemon Drop Mom. Lemon Drop Mom's going to inherit that lead almost, as nobody really eager to go in the early going, and Lemon Drop Mom, still under a tight hold, leads it by about a length and a quarter. Maria's Golden Rose, Eurydice, moves up on the outside. New Edition settles toward the inside. Prom Party also under a tight hold, followed by Miss Tizzy Now, and your trailer is Cabbage Key. As they make their way into that first turn, you can see by the quarter how slow they were going, 25-4. And on the front end, going comfortably on the front end, is Lemon Drop Mom by a length and a half. Maria's Golden Rose racing second, followed by Eurydice in third. New Edition toward the inside. Miss Tizzy Now has moved up with the rail. Up on the outside, Prom Party and Cabbage Key, the trailer, they're cantering down the backstretch, continuing that rather tepid tempo. And on the front end, it's still Lemon Drop Mom. Half goes in 51-1. As they continue to breeze down the backstretch with Lemon Drop Mom right alongside Maria's Golden Rose. Up on the outside, Eurydice. Toward the inside, Miss Tizzy Now, followed by New Edition, then Prom Party, and Cabbage Key is the trailer. As they race into the turn, the tempo surely to quicken now. On the front end, Lemon Drop Mom, right there, Maria's Golden Rose, followed by Miss Tizzy Now in a good spot in third. New Edition is trying to kick it in, followed by Eurydice there, bunching up with 3/8 to go. Lemon Drop Mom. Miss Tizzy Now had nowhere to go. Has to angle off the inside. Four of them across the track. Lemon Drop Mom. New Edition is spurting, as is Eurydice, as they head for home. New Edition to the front. Eurydice on the outside. Lemon Drop Mom on the extreme outside. Cabbage Key trying to kick in. Miss Tizzy Now with a seam, but it may be too late. New Edition to the front on the outside. Here comes Miss Tizzy Now, but it's New Edition. Miss Tizzy Now. Cabbage Key, a late rally. New Edition's going to win it. Miss Tizzy Now second, followed by Prom Party. That was Prom Party getting up for third, followed by Lemon Drop Mom fourth.
New Edition getting the victory here from just off the pace, a length and three quarters. There was a steward's inquiry following a claim of foul by the rider of Eurydice, but it did not stand, and New Edition keeps her victory at pretty nice mutual, $11 mutual, after finishing second by only a nose to Miss Tizzy Now in the St. George's right here at Delaware Park. Miss Tizzy Now completing the exacta with Prom Party, a recent maiden breaker from New York, shipping in for the Dogwood Stable and Todd Pletcher to finish in the third spot. The winner, New Edition, is a chestnut filly, a daughter of Stormy Atlantic, from Sashay Away by Farm Away. Bred in Kentucky by the Woodland Farm and owned by the breeder, trained by Larry Jones and ridden to victory by Gabriel Saez, New Edition covers the mile in the 16th on the firm Delaware turf and won 44-3. We're going to stay in the Mid-Atlantic for a pair of stakes races now from Monmouth Park in New Jersey, beginning with the Grade 3 Boiling Springs on Saturday afternoon. Once again, three-year-old fillies at a mile on the 16th. Let's head down to Monmouth and the Boiling Springs.
They're racing in the Boiling Springs. Full of ideas, had a good beginning. Sharp Susan to the outside is prominent early, but very hard held as Red Birkin tracks them in third position. Then More Than a Feeling, followed by Dinner Break on the outside. And the favorite, Rutherian, is down at the rail in the back early, seven off the lead, as Sharp Susan gets ahead, full of ideas, running for the clubhouse turn. It is Sharp Susan in front. Now clearing and opening up two from Full of Ideas, who's second by a length and a half to Red Birkin and Dinner Break. Then Rutherian down on the inside, five off the lead, and More Than a Feeling is right next to her. The first quarter, 24-1. Sharp Susan and Eddie Castro lead the way to the back stretch, prompted along by Full of Ideas, who's second by 2.5 lengths. Red Birkin and Dinner Break together, third and fourth. Rutherian is fifth along the inside and racing 5.5 from the front. More Than a Feeling continues to race right alongside as they go by a half mile in 47-4. It is Sharp Susan, who's been there all the way and is in front by almost two lengths into the turn. Full of Ideas second, Red Birkin down on the inside, traveling well enough. She's got two lengths to make up. And following her will be the favorite, Ruth Ariane, who's down on the inside. Three and a half lengths off the lead. And then it's Dinner Break and More Than a Feeling. They're into the stretch. Sharp Susan in front. Red Birkin, and here comes Ruth Ariane to the outside of them. Red Birkin takes the lead. Ruth Ariane is coming. Sharp Susan is back to third. It is Red Birkin. Ruth Ariane and Sharp Susan. Red Birkin on the inside. Ruth Ariane trying to get by her, but Red Birkin won't let her. And Red Birkin won it. Ruth Ariane was second best, and then came Sharp Susan and Dinner Break.
Ruth Ariane gets the victory on the disqualification of Red Birkin. Red Birkin did cause a little bit of trouble. In fact, there were a couple of claims against her, including one made by Sharp Susan's rider, Eddie Castro. But she did end up crossing the line first by a neck, but after drifting out in the stretch and causing interference, she did get disqualified, placed third. The winner now, Ruth Ariane, coming in with three consecutive victories, first of them being Restricted Stake in New York, followed up by the Sands Point, and now the Grade 3 Boiling Springs. Sharp Susan gets moved to second, Red Birkin to third. Ruth Ariane is a dark bayer brown filly, a daughter of Pulpit from Ruthian by Rahi. Bred in Kentucky by the Payson Stud and owned by Virginia Craft Payson Limited and trained by Roger Atfield, ridden to victory by Jose Lescano, Ruth Ariane covers the mile in the 16th at Monmouth on the turf in 140 and 3. We'll head back to the New Jersey turf for the running on Sunday afternoon of the Classy Briefcase. Fillies and mares going a short distance, 5.5 furlongs on the grass. Let's return to New Jersey and the Classy Briefcase.
Racing in the Classy Briefcase, and Brassy Boots stumbled coming out of there. Pure Disco and Serena's Cat for the front. Then Brassy Boots, Hattie Be Good. Cherokee Jewel will sit last early, 5 lengths off the lead as Pure Disco runs along up front. Pure Disco on top by 3/4 of a length. Serena's Cat to the outside, second. Brassy Boots, third. Hattie Be Good secures the rail, fourth. 2 lengths off the lead and two in front of Cherokee Jewel. The first quarter, not fast, 22 4/5 seconds, and Pure Disco sets the pace. On top by a length and a half over Serena's Cat on the far turn. And then it's Brassy Boots. Hattie Be Good is on the inside. Cherokee Jewel still 5 lengths to make up. Pure Disco turning for home in front. Leads by a length to Hattie Be Good, who's closing up the rail. Pure Disco now takes the rail away from Hattie Be Good. Got to switch outside. Then Serena's Cat, followed by Brassy Boots. Pure Disco still there. Serena's Cat. Serena's Cat, Pure Disco, Bob Heads, either one. Serena's Cat or Pure Disco, Cherokee Jewel up for third.
It was a head bob finish. Track announcer Larry Colmus couldn't separate them. I had a hard time with it too. Serena's Cat gets her nose down on the wire at 5.5-1 mutual with a late surge under a persevering ride from Eddie Castro. Pure Disco at 8.5-1, who had opened up a fairly comfortable lead. Looked like she might be home free by the top of the stretch, but Eddie Castro able to get her with Serena's Cat. Cherokee Jewel completes the order of the top three. Not a particularly good trip for the favored Hattie Be Good. The odds on choice in here did have a little bit of a difficult time getting trapped down on the rail throughout the running here. Never really had clear sailing, but came up flat in the stretch to finish fourth. Serena's Cat is a dark bayer brown filly, a daughter of Stormcat from Serena's Tune by Mr. Prospector, bred in Kentucky by Hillendale Farm and Edward McGee, owned by the Dell Ridge Farm and trained by Karen McLaughlin, ridden to victory by Eddie Castro. Serena's Cat covers the 5.5 on the turf in 102 and 3. We're going to head to Churchill Downs next, where on Saturday afternoon they ran the Firecracker Breeders' Cup, a Grade 2 mile on the grass. Let's head to Kentucky and the running of the Firecracker.
Off and running in the Firecracker. Good even start. Remarkable News rockets out at the hedge to take the lead and clears off quickly by a length and a half. Taganello far outside, second out. Performance Racing in third. Obi-Wan Kenobi forwardly placed in fourth by an Ecto Crested fifth. Vegas Lord next by a half to Brilliant, who's hugging that hedge, and three back to Free Thinking, who trails on the clubhouse turn. Remarkable News and Ramon Dominguez take him along under a snug hole by a length and a quarter. Long shot Taganello tracking from second. Crested moves on the outside into third. Outperformance is racing in mid-pack, fourth by an Ecta Obi-Wan Kenobi, Vega's Lord. Six lengths off the lead, a length in front of Brilliant now, and two farther back to Free Thinking, who's at the back of the pack, up the backside. Quarter 24 and 1/5 seconds. Remarkable News in command early, leading it by a length and a quarter still. Tiganello inching up to the outside in second. Crested a close-up third. Obi-Wan Kenobi down on the inside, racing in fourth. Outperformance now 4.5 off the lead in fifth. Brilliant inching up the inside into striking range. Then Vega's Lord and Free Thinking driving at the back of the pack. Half in 47 and 4. Easy fraction so far for Remarkable News. Off the turn at the quarter pole, leading it clear by two as they straighten away. Remarkable News set down now by Dominguez, responding gamely. Opens up now by three. The rails opened up for Brilliant, who's charging up into second along the inside. Then Obi-Wan Kenobi, but it's Remarkable News in command every step of the way, leading it by three. Brilliant running nicely. Cannot get to him. Remarkable News and Ramon Dominguez wire to wire in the firecracker. Brilliant was second. Outperformance third. Crested ran fourth.
Remarkable News, another nice effort by this guy who won the Dixie last time out. Unfortunately, that race marred by an accident in front of him that kind of gave him a little bit of clear sailing. This time, there was no such problem. He was on the lead every step of the way. However, without anybody really threatening, won by almost three over Brilliant without performance, stalking the pace in the early going, settling back a little bit, and then re-rallying to finish third. Remarkable News is a chestnut horse, a son of Chaim from Unreachable by Al Haras. He was bred in Venezuela by the Agro Pecuaria Louisiana and is owned by Holly Rincon, trained by Angel Pena Jr. and ridden to victory by Ramon Dominguez. Remarkable News covers the mile on the Churchill Downs turf in 134 and 3. We're going to head to Prairie Meadows now for a series of races over the weekend, beginning on Friday evening with the Sailorville Stakes. $100,000 fillies and mares sprinting. Let's head to Prairie Meadows in Iowa and the Sailorville.
Off and running in the Sailorville. Country Diva between horses takes off for the lead. Flashy Lady is right there. Gleaming Elegance along the inside in Fiery Pursuit right there as well. Miss Macy Sue getting caught a little bit wide here down the back stretch. And there goes Gleaming Elegance for Louis Quinones and takes off down the inside and has a length lead. Flashy Lady is in second. Country Diva between horses there with Miss Macy Sue to the outside, about three lengths off the lead. Fiery Pursuit has dropped back second to last and Ready to Please. And John Velasquez trails about four lengths off the lead. They went the opening quarter in 21 and 3 around the turn, and Gleaming Elegance is on top. She opens up here by a 3. Gleaming Elegance leads. Miss Macy Sue is in second. Then after that, Ready to Please starting to come on from the back of the pack. They hit the top of the stretch. Gleaming Elegance has been caught. Miss Macy Sue to the outside. Ready to Please 3 wide to the outside. After that, Country Diva, they're in the stretch drive and between horses. Miss Macy Sue now on top. Gleaming Elegance trying to re-rally in second. The whip's out and Ready to Please in third, and Country Diva's next up in fourth. It's Miss Macy Sue under a hand ride from Larry Sterling Jr., and she takes off for home. Here's Miss Macy Sue to win the Sailorville. Ready to Please was second, and Country Diva up for the show in 108 and 3.
Miss Macy Sue, this filly has really turned around of late. She's really developed into a pretty solid campaigner here for her connections. Just rallies from just off the pace, showed good speed early, was never far out of it. Forwardly placed, made a nice bid to the lead, and won off by 2.5 lengths as the odds-on favorite from Ready to Please with Country Diva at 15-1. Very wide in the stretch, completing the order of the top three. Miss Macy Sue, a dark brayer brown filly, a daughter of Trippy from Yada Yada by Great Above, was bred in Florida by Brian J. Howlett, owned by Roll Reroll Stable and trained by Kelly Von Hemmel, ridden to victory by Larry Sterling Jr. Miss Macy Sue covers the 6 furlongs at Prairie Meadows in 108 and 3. Next up, the Grade 3 Iowa Oaks, 3-year-old fillies at a mile and a 16th. Let's return to Prairie Meadows and the Iowa Oaks.
Off and running in the Iowa Oaks, and there goes the Iowa-bred Irish Party. And Irish Party takes off for the lap to go, being chased by Alba Daba Secret early. High again, and David Flores is right there in third behind the dueling leaders with Marietta wide to the outside. Swift Temper is next up along the inside. Then it's across the border. Humble Janet Camarillo is second last, and the trailer at the back of the pack is Robbie Alvarado and La Chateau. They're well spread out over a lot of ground as they go through the opening quarter. Irish Party to the inside at Alba Catadaba Secret, and these two are right together through an opening quarter of 23-1. They are six lengths clear of High Again next up, with Swift Temper to the inside, and Marietta and Rafael Barano to the outside, about eight from the lead. Another five back. Two across the border. Then it's Humboldt Janet a long way back to Camarillo, and La Chateau is still a long way back. Has to be at least 15 to 20 lengths off the lead with a half mile to go. And it's on top. Alba Daba Secret, Irish Party back to second. Now High Again is within a length of the lead and closing up. There goes Marietta, has a shot there. Swift Temper is behind runners. After that, it is across the border. Moving in from the back of the pack is Humboldt Janet, and La Chateau is winding up from behind. High Again and David Flores get to the top now. Marietta to the outside in second. After that, it is Irish Party dropping back a bit, and Humboldt Janet is running on from the back of the pack. They hit the top of the stretch. Marietta to the outside of High Again. These two are right together through the final 3/16. Humboldt Janet is still closing in from the back of the pack to be two lengths from the top pair inside the final furlong. Marietta has the lead just ahead of High Again back into second. Humboldt Janet and La Chateau, but it is Marietta and Rafael Barano to win the Iowa Oaks. Humboldt Janet was second. After that, High Again dropped back to third. La Chateau finishes in fourth. The time here, 1:43 flat.
Marietta, very good effort here. Darley Stable turning up in all kinds of places these days here at Prairie Meadows to pick up a length and three-quarter victory from just off the pace, taking over with a pretty nice move at about the 3/16 pole under Rafael Bejarano to win over 25-1 long shot Humboldt Janet, who rallied strongly from off the pace as the odds-on favorite High Again got to the lead but had nothing to offer when Marietta made her rally. Marietta, a dark Bayer Brown filly, a daughter of Machiavellian from Minister Wife by Deputy Minister, was bred in Kentucky by Darley and is owned by the breeder, trained by Owen Hardy, and ridden to victory by Rafael Bejarano. Marietta covers the mile in the 16th of the Iowa Oaks in 1:43 flat. We'll head right back to Prairie Meadows and Friday evening's running of the ungraded Iowa Derby, $250,000 a mile in the 16th for three-year-olds. Let's head back to Prairie Meadows, the Iowa Derby.
They're all in the gate. Off and running in the Iowa Derby. And Visions in Color is going for the early lead, but now there goes Flash Storm to take over. Who Let the Cat In is right there. Winstrella and John Velasquez is up close as well. Try to Fly and Joe Talamo in a little tight in between horses. Around the first turn they wheel with 7/8 to go, and Flash Storm is on top. Who Let the Cat In a little bit wide in second. Winstrella in a good striking spot to the inside in third, and Try to Fly and Joe Talamo right there close up fourth. Then it's Greeley's Conquest in between horses. Visions in Color way to the outside. Loose Leaf is up close. Loose Leaf about seven from the lead. They're well bunched up front. Then it's Sahara Heat to the inside. Codeo, they're really stacked up. Then it's a long way back to Delightful Kiss, and Going Ballistic is the trailer. They continue up the back stretch with on the inside Flash Storm, and to the outside Who Let the Cat In. They're right together. Greeley's Conquest sneaking up there to the outside in third with a half mile to go. Winstrella is next up. Try to Fly, the first to be pushed along there as they still are bunched up around the turn. Loose Leaf is moving through. Visions in Color is still right there about seven from the lead. Sahara Heat drops back a bit. Codeo passes that one. Delightful Kiss starting to unwind from the back of the pack. Here comes Delightful Kiss, who is really flying, and Going Ballistic is closing in as well, and they come to the top of the stretch, and Loose Leaf is the new leader. It's Loose Leaf now taking over the lead and draws clear. Flash Storm is still there in second. Winstrella is under urging in third, and Delightful Kiss is still rolling from the back of the pack. Loose Leaf and Flash Storm. Flash Storm is still there. Loose Leaf in the middle, and Delightful Kiss to the outside. Try to Fly. Going Ballistic is running on late, but there goes Delightful Kiss to take over, and Delightful Kiss goes on to win the Iowa Derby. Delightful Kiss and Jeff Sanchez. Flash Storm was second, going to be very close for the show. Either a light charging Going Ballistic or Try to Fly, but it was a Delightful Kiss winning the Iowa Derby. The time here, 1:42 flat.
Delightful Kiss, last time out, picked up the victory in the Ohio Derby at 24-1. They still weren't really believing in this guy. Went off at over 5-1, won off nicely with his usual late charging style, rallying from very far back with a six wide bid to win by a length and a quarter over the Speedball's Flash Storm and going ballistic, rallying well to finish in the third spot. Flash Storm, a very enterprising race, once again on or near the pace every step of the way, but it was in fact a contested pace. May have cost him in the end, but he still hung around pretty well at almost 60-1. The winner, Delightful Kiss, is a gray or roan three-year-old gelding, a son of Kiss and Chris from Deputy's Delight by French Deputy. Bred in Florida by the Hobo Farm Limited and owned by the breeder, trained by Pete Anderson. You may remember Delightful Kiss from his fourth place finish in the Arkansas Derby behind subsequent classic winner Curlin. Obviously, this guy has developed very nicely, a very patient training job by his trainer, former rider Pete Anderson. Ridden to victory by Jeffrey Sanchez, Delightful Kiss covers the mile in the 16th and 1 minute 42 flat. We're going to pause now for a brief message. When we return, we'll be finishing up the weekend's action at Prairie Meadows, heading north of the border to Woodbine, and of course out west to California. Please stay with us. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We're going to remain at Prairie Meadows now and complete the weekend's action, starting out with the Iowa Distaff Breeders' Cup on Saturday. $125,000 for fillies and mares. Let's head back to Prairie Meadows, the Iowa Distaff.
Off and running. Turbulent Thinking bounces out of there very quickly and goes for the early lead. Plaid is right there in second with Brownie Points to the inside. Leah's Secret and Mark Guidry is about four lengths off the lead early on. Then there's another gap of four lengths further back to Soul Search, and Dynamin is the early trailer. To the 7/8 pole they go, and Turbulent Thinking shows the way. Brownie Points is right there in second with Plaid to the outside racing in third. Leah's Secret is next up in fourth, about four lengths off the lead. Another five back to Soul Search, who's clear of Dynamin. They just went past the three-quarter pole there, and Turbulent Thinking leads them on to the back stretch. Brownie Points is still in second, Plaid in third, no change among the top three. Then Leah's Secret bounces along in fourth, still five from the front. Another four back to Soul Search and Dynabin. They continue their run up the back stretch to the half-mile pole, and Turbulent Thinking continues to lead. Brownie Points is still second, Plaid in third, and Leah's Secret continues to run along in fourth, Soul Search and Dynabin. They just went past the half-mile pole, down to the second turn. Turbulent Thinking trying to lead every step of the way, leads him around the second turn. Brownie Points is in second, Plaid is in third. Leah's Secret is now pushed along in fourth. Soul Search going to take the inside route, and Dynamin, they race to the top of the stretch. Turbulent Thinking, now there goes Brownie Points and Plaid, these two to challenge the leader. Turbulent Thinking drops back now, they hit the top of the stretch. Brownie Points in between horses takes off for home now. Leah's Secret now circulates the field to the outside. Plaid is right there as well, and now taking off for home, it's Brownie Points. Plaid to the outside in second, and after that it's Soul Search running on from the back of the pack. Brownie Points is on top. Brownie Points leads Plaid. Here's Plaid with a lunge to the outside. Brownie Points and Louis Canonis trying to hold on, and will, and Brownie Points wins the Iowa Distaff. Plaid was second. A late charging Dynabin edges out Soul Search for third. It's Brownie Points and Louis Canonis in the Iowa Distaff in a time of 1:43.4.
Brownie Points, another very solid Midwestern campaigner here for Donnie Von Hemmel, showing good early speed, seizing control at about the quarter pole, winning by 3/4 of a length from the very determined Plaid, who rallied solidly while wide. Dynabin rallies from well back off the pace at 49-1 to complete the order of the top three. Brownie Points is a chestnut filly, daughter of Forest Wildcat from Stylish Society by 49er. Bred in Kentucky by the Pin Oak Stud Limited and owned by Pin Oak Stable, trained by Donnie Von Hemmel and ridden to victory by Luis Quinones. Brownie Points covers the mile in the 16th of Prairie Meadows in 1:43.4. Next up, the Prairie Meadows Cornhusker, Grade 2, $300,000. For older horses, let's head back to Prairie Meadows and the Cornhusker.
They're all in the gate. Off and running and stumbling there at the start was Deputy Glitters. And Jonesboro charges through with the orange cap to take the lead early on. Being chased by Silent Pleasure, who is right there in second. Smokey Jones Sutton is a close-up third. And Patriot Act in fourth. Deputy Glitters has recovered to run fifth, just four lengths off the lead early on. Then Wayzata Bay to the inside. Dry Martini toward the back. It's Barbican to the outside there. And the trailer is More Than Regal. Less than 7/8 to go. And it's Jones leading the way. Racing in second there, it's Silent Pleasure. Back into third, it's Smokey Jones Sutton. And Deputy Glitters is in fourth. Patriot Act in fifth along the inside, just four from the lead. Dry Martini splitting the mirror for Trujillo is about five lengths off the lead, but has to run through traffic. Wayzata Bay is up close along the inside. Barbican is second last, and More Than Regal is the trailer. They continue their run up the back stretch here in the Cornhusker, and on top it's Jonesboro, surrounded now by Silent Pleasure in second. Smokey Jones Sutton in between horses there. Dry Martini right there. Patriot Act's going to need room along the inside. Deputy Glitters is just two from the lead. Wayzata Bay is right behind traffic there. Barbican is second last, and More Than Regal is the trailer. The whole group covered by nine lengths as they round the far turn. Jonesboro is still on top there. It's Jonesboro just on the lead. But now to the outside. There goes Silent Pleasure. And Silent Pleasure, the first to kick for home. They're two furlongs from the finish now. Silent Pleasure is on top. Jonesboro trying to re-rally up into a second. Here they come in the stretch drive, and Silent Pleasure is on top. Now moving up, here comes Dry Martini. Dry Martini, Elvis Trujillo trying to win it for the second consecutive year. Jonesboro to the inside. Dry Martini gets to the front. Silent Pleasure drops back in second. Patriot Act is running on from behind, but there goes Dry Martini and Elvis Trujillo to win the Cornhusker. Silent Pleasure was second. Patriot Act was third, and it is Dry Martini. Elvis Trujillo takes the Cornhusker for the second year in a row. In 1:48.2.
Dry Martini, you may remember this guy from getting pretty good over the winter time down at Gulfstream Park, won a couple of pretty impressive allowance and money allowance races, moved into stakes company, grade three company, in fact, last time out at Calder at the Memorial Day Handicap, picked up a victory there, now picks up the lion's share of a $300,000 purse out of town as they head into the Midwest and pick up a solid victory here by a length and three quarters over Silent Pleasure with the favorite Patriot Act launching his usual bid, although not quite as far back as he has often run in the past to finish third. The winner, Dry Martini, is a gray or roan gelded son of Slew Gin Fizz from Johns Kimberly by Criminal Type. Bred in Florida by Carol and Marty Hirsch and owned by Carol and George Nyron, trained by Barkley Tag and ridden to victory by Elvis Trujillo. Dry Martini covers the nine furlongs at Prairie Meadows in 1:48.2. We're going to head north of the border now. Woodbine, the home of the Dominion Day, a grade three for older horses going long on the Polytrack surface Sunday afternoon, will join the Dominion Day in progress.
And it's True Metropolitan, isolated on the lead as they head toward the backstretch. The opening half mile was in 47.2. True Metropolitan, down on the inside, still under a snug hold. Getaway Candidate has moved within a length. Palladio's up close, just 2.5 lengths off the lead and currently third. Shillelagh Slew's getting a little nudge from Luciani. Then Mustanfar, who has 3.5 to come, and trailing his Colorful Judgment. True Metropolitan leads through 3/4 of a mile in 1:12. And it's True Metropolitan with 3 furlongs to go. Mustanfar is making a menacing move on the outside, comes into second. Palladio's down to the inside, third, and a length and a half off the lead, but True Metropolitan really hasn't been asked with 1/4 of a mile to go. Cable takes a peek under his shoulder and sees Mustanfar as they turn for home, and it's True Metropolitan still under a hand ride. Mustanfar is in an all-out drive. Now the whip is out on True Metropolitan. Cable has set him down. It's True Metropolitan on the inside. On the outside, Mustanfar. True Metropolitan. All class, all guts. He holds on to win the Dominion Day, defeating Mustanfar and Palladio with Colorful Judgment fourth.
True Metropolitan, who was last year's Older Horse Sovereign Award winner for the older or handicapped division in Canada, got to the front end, as he often does, and never looked back, was able to hold on by a half a length from Mooston Far. Top of the stretch, it looked like Mooston Far would probably get by him, but True Metropolitan did have another gear, plenty left to hold off under Todd Cable. Palladio finishing in the third spot as the favorite. A lot more expected from this guy, who ran a kind of a one-pace effort to settle for third. The winner, True Metropolitan, a dark bay or brown gelded son of Proud and True from Forest Dunes by Green Forest, was bred in Florida by Frank Bertolino and is owned by Bob Chima. Trained by Terry Jordan and ridden to victory by Todd Cable, True Metropolitan covers the mile and a quarter on the poly track surface in 2:04.1. We're going to head next to the West Coast. A lot of great stakes racing action on Saturday afternoon at Hollywood Park, beginning with the American Invitational, a Grade 2 mile on the grass. Let's head out to California. I'm sorry, a mile and an eighth on the grass. Let's head out to California and the American Invitational.
They're off. Willow O'Wisp broke beautifully and goes immediately to the front. The Tin Man and Bay Crux away second and third, Right Special just outside of them. Then Out of Control and Fast and Furious is at the back of the pack as they run into the clubhouse turn, and the fast start has Willow O'Wisp, a three-quarter length leader from the Tin Man, who tracks in second. Right Special and a four wide Out of Control are third and fourth. Bay Crux stays at the rail fifth, he's three from the front, and Fast and Furious is the trailer as they turn into the backstretch. In the 68th running of the American Invitational Handicap, and Willow O'Wisp is the leader. He is a half length in front of defending champion, the Tin Man, who is closer now in second. Out of Control in the red, Green Cap is third and a length and three quarters from the lead. Right Special reserved between horses. Bay Crux at the rail, they're both three from the lead. And Fast and Furious is at the back of the pack as they head up the back stretch. Four and a half furlongs from the wire, Willow O'Wisp and a closer, the Tin Man. Willow O'Wisp is only a neck in front. The Tin Man just waiting for the go signal from Victor Espinosa, races second. Out of Control will be wide on both turns, but he's within a length of the lead. Right Special and Bay Crux now two from the front. Fast and Furious has trailed throughout, and they run around the far turn. Willow O'Wisp and the Tin Man are now even to the quarter mile marker. Out of Control is within a neck of the lead. Then comes Right Special. Bay Crux nowhere to go yet. Fast and Furious, and we have a new leader. It's the Tin Man, but he's immediately confronted by Out of Control to the outside. These two to the final furlong. Right Special, Fast and Furious, Out of Control just in front. The Tin Man battles back to the outside. Fast and Furious, these three to the wire. Out of Control, the Tin Man's back to second. Out of Control. The 68th American Invitational Handicap won by Out of Control over the Tin Man. Fast and Furious third, Bay Crux fourth.
Out of Control getting his head down on the wire in advance of the Tin Man in a very exciting stretch run here. Could have gone any number of ways at the top of the stretch with a lot of horses in contention, but Out of Control made that terrific move and just got the job done. By the top of the stretch, he was starting to look like he was going to take command. The Tin Man never giving up, winning or finishing in second. It was a half a length back to Fast and Furious, rallying for third. The winner, Out of Control, a dark bay or brown son of Vittori from Heavenly Dancer by Fitzcarraldo, was bred in Brazil by Stud TNT and is owned by the breeder, trained by Bobby Frankel, who, after having his barn a little bit quiet in the last couple of months, has really come to life in the early portion of the summer. Ridden to victory by Michael Bays, Out of Control covers the mile and an eighth on the Hollywood turf in 1:46.4. Next up, two-year-old fillies in the Land of Lucy, $100,000, six furlongs for the babies. Let's head back to Hollywood Park and the running of the Land of Lucy.
They're off. Billy Bob broke running, so did the Golden Noodle and another Elena, but Billy Bob is fastest. Ever So Pretty now up into second. Set Play is next. Then My Little Cokie and Treadmill with Elocution and the Golden Noodle, and the trailer is Alpine Yodel. Ever So Pretty is quicker than Billy Bob up the back stretch. Ever So Pretty, three quarters in front. Billy Bob is at the rail in second, a length and a half to another Elena and Treadmill, together third and fourth and two and a half behind. Then comes Set Play, fifth in the red with three and a half to come. Elocution just just passed my little Koki, 5 from the front. It's 6 lengths to the Golden Noodle and 2 lengths last to Alpine Yodel as they fire to the top of the stretch in the 63rd Landalusi. Here's Set Play outside of Ever So Pretty. Set Play puts our head in front of Ever So Pretty, who battles on. Billy Bob is at the rail. Elocution is 5 wide turning into the stretch and still 4 lengths behind. Then comes Treadmill. The Golden Noodle has made up a lot of ground and Set Play is narrowly in front. Ever So Pretty backs off. Here comes the Golden Noodle running a very big race. Treadmill is just inside of her. Elocution nothing, and the Golden Noodle has taken over the lead. Treadmill is second. Set Play is third. The Golden Noodle in front. The Golden Noodle won by 3.5 over Treadmill in second, Set Play third, and Billy Bob fourth.
The Golden Noodle, the second longest price on the board at 33-1, picks up the victory, breaking her maiden. In fact, with this effort in her third career start, she settled back a little bit on the wide side in the early portion of the race, moved up on the inside, and then came out at the top of the stretch to rally very strongly under Clinton Potts to win by 3.5 lengths over Treadmill, with Set Play back in the third spot. Kind of disappointing in here was the favorite, Elocution, coming in off a very impressive track last time out, and a legitimate favorite at that. She rallied a little bit, but was caught a little bit wide, didn't have the easiest of trips, and had to settle for fifth. The winner, the Golden Noodle. A chestnut filly, a daughter of De Wildcat from Golden Genie by Bo Genius, was bred in Montana by Bill Feely and is owned by the breeder, trained by Jack Van Berg, and ridden to victory by Clinton Potts. The Golden Noodle covers the 6 furlongs of the Landalusi in 1:11 and 2. We're going to head out to California once more for Saturday afternoon's Grade 1 stakes feature, the Hollywood Gold Cup. Of course, older horses going 1.25 miles on that cushion track surface. Let's head out to California and the Gold Cup.
They're set. They're off. Lava Man broke beautifully and goes right out for the front. AP Excellent now moves through at the rail, and AP Excellent will take charge. Lava Man away sharply today. Wilco is in third with St. Stephan at the rail, and AP Arrow away fifth. My Creed is at the rail in sixth. Then comes Big Booster and Porfido, and stretch running Molengau is at the back of the pack as they go into the clubhouse turn. AP Excellent is the boss early. It is AP Excellent. He strides away nicely to lead Lava Man by a solid 3 lengths. Wilco angles to the inside to save ground to the backstretch. He's 3.5 from the front running AP Excellent. AP Arrow is fourth with 5 lengths to make up. St. Stephan is at the rail. He is 6.5 behind the front runner. Then comes My Creed and Russell Bays, 8 from the lead. Big Booster, Porfido, and Molengau all 11 behind as they head up the backstretch in the 68th Hollywood Gold Cup, and AP Excellent has had it easy in the first half mile. AP Excellent leads by 1.5 lengths. 2-time defending champion Lava Man now closer in second. Lava Man is 1.25 lengths from the lead. At the rail goes Wilco. He's 2 from the front. AP Arrow pushed along now. He's dropped 4 lengths off the pace. St. Stephan stays at the rail. Molengau is just past 3. He is within 5.5 lengths of the lead. Porfido, Mike Creed, and Big Booster at the back of the pack. 3 furlongs left to run. AP Excellent tries to go it all the way. Lava Man looms large outside of him. Here's Lava Man within a head of the lead. Molengau is about to move into third, and the stage is set as Lava Man has taken over the lead. He'll have to deal with Molengau, who's under the whip and 2 lengths from the front. AP Excellent is back to third. AP Excellent is battling back inside of Lava Man. Lava Man is only ahead in front. AP Excellent battles on bravely and maybe even retakes the lead. Lava Man to the outside. AP Excellent at the rail. Big Booster 1.5 lengths from the front. Lava Man, AP Excellent, Big Booster, Lava Man, yes! There's the original Rags to Riches. Lava Man did it again by a nose. AP Excellent and Big Booster.
Lava Man got his head down in a determined effort. AP Excellent, as expected, taking command in the early going. Lava Man broke alertly, got into his usual position just off the early pace, and the two of them ran around the racetrack in that position just about every step to the top of the stretch. Corey Nakatani asked Lava Man for a solid effort. He did come up a little bit flat at first. He actually swung a little bit wide. Perhaps they expected AP Excellent to back up, but the fractions early were a little bit slower than he had had been running, and as a result, Lava Man had to work a little bit harder to catch him. It was a nose finish with the three horses across the track. AP Excellent on the inside, Lava Man in the middle, and Big Booster, who you may remember from the Kimmel Barn a couple of years ago in New York, is out to California now for Mike Mitchell. He was recently gelded and obviously seems to like running on that all-weather surface as well. Rallies from well back at 24-1 to finish third. The winner, a Lava Man, repeating this race for the third time, tying the record set back in the 1960s by another Calbred gelding, that Native Diver, a champion in his own right in his era, and Lava Man has now duplicated that rather difficult performance here, and in a sense a little bit more difficult in that he has done it now on two surfaces because, of course, this race run on the all-weather surface this year for the first time. Lava Man, a dark Bayer Brown gelded son of Slough City Slough from Little Miss Leonard by Nostalgia Star, was bred in California by Lonnie Arterburn, Eve and Kim Kuhlman. He is owned by the STD Racing Stable and Jason Wood, trained by Doug O'Neill and ridden to victory by Corey Nakatani. Lava Man completes the mile and a quarter in 2:03.1. We are going to pause for one more brief message, and when we return, we'll be finishing up the weekend stakes racing action at Hollywood Park and heading home to New York as well. Please stay with us. Welcome back. We're going to continue Horses and Courses in Southern California. Sunday afternoon stakes feature the Beverly Hills. Three and up fillies and mares at a mile and a quarter on the turf. Let's head back to California and the Beverly Hills.
They're off. Perfect start. Citronade, Nadi Rafaela, and Andrea show the most speed, but it is Citronade to take charge at once. Nakaba angles to the inside, and the early trailer is Mabadi. Out of the chute and about to hook up with the main course, and Citronade is uncontested with one lap to go. She leads Andrea by two lengths. Nadi Rafaela is reserved by Alex Solis. She races in third and about three and a half from her stablemate. Nakaba's at the rail. And Mabadi is at the back of the pack, six lengths from first to last. Easy lead for Citronade as she goes into the clubhouse turn and does it smoothly and smartly. Citronade, the big favorite, and David Flores lead by three lengths. Andrea continues to track from second. Nadi Rafaela is just outside of Nakaba. They're together third and fourth, and about four from Citronade. And then Mabadi at the back of the pack, and Citronade even slows it down more to the backstretch, just crawls along now. Citronade's lead is just a length from Andrea because David Flores just backed her right up into Andrea to take a breather to the backstretch. So Citronade is once again uncontested, and she opens up her lead to two lengths again from Andrea, who's now pushed along just a bit by Michael Bays. And now Citronade starts to strut her stuff up the backstretch, and she has opened up four lengths without being asked at all. Andrea races in second. Nadi Rafaela is pushed along a bit. Nakaba's at the rail, and Mabadi is the trailer, and there's just over three furlongs to run in the 42nd Beverly Hills Handicap. Absolutely no excuses for Citronade, going for her fifth win in a row, and she runs to the quarter pole three lengths in front of Andrea, who's all in now. Nadi Rafaela is put to a full-out drive. Nakaba's at the rail, and Mabadi is still the trailer, and Citronade is to the top of the stretch, and she leads by three. Andrea is second, Nadi Rafaela is third, then Mabadi and Nakaba, and they come to the final furlong, and Citronade maintains a three-length lead. Andrea is running a very good race, but she's only second best. Nadia Raffaella and Nakaba. It's just another walk in the Hollywood Park for Citronade, five in a row. Citronade wins the 42nd. Beverly Hills by 3 1/4. Andrea second, close for third. Mabadi, Nakaba, and Nadia Raffaella.
Citronade making it really look like a one-horse race. She got to the lead, as she usually does, in a bit of a gallop. Was able to slow the fractions down 50.17, 114.20. This is a very high-quality Grade 1 winning mare, picking up her fifth win in a row, and nobody went out to offer any sort of a challenge. Andrea, a New Zealand-bred import, running second every step of the way. Naughty Raffaella running third just about every step of the way around the track. The winner, Citronade, Bay Filly, a four-year-old daughter of Lemon Drop Kid from primarily by Lord at War, was bred in Kentucky by Adina Springs and is owned by the Stronach Stable, trained by Bobby Frankel and ridden to victory by David Flores. Completing her fifth in a row, Citronade runs the 1 1/4 on the Hollywood turf in 2:01 and 2. We're going to head home to New York now for a four-pack of stakes over the weekend at Belmont Park, beginning with the Grade 1 Mother Goose for three-year-old fillies at 9 furlongs on the Belmont main track. Let's head down to New York in the call of the Mother Goose.
And they're off. And Bold Assurance is hustled right out of there by Garrett Gomez, and he wants that lead, and he's got it. And it is Bold Assurance who has established the early lead very early on. Lady Joanna's come on running in second, and the favorite, Octave, settles back in third position as Boca Grand lumbers along the last of four as the field moves down the backstretch run. So Gomez is nursing that speed of Bold Assurance through a quarter that goes in 23 2/5 seconds. Calvin Burrell's got a very good hold of Lady Joanne, and Johnny Velasquez has maneuvered Octave. Octave's been maneuvered to the outside, clear of trouble in third position. Then a break of another 4 or 5 lengths now, back to Boca Grand, the trailer. The first quarter went in 23 2. The half goes in 46 1. The pace is strong, and Bold Assurance is the leader, still there by a length. Lady Joanne still flanking her, and on the far outside, Octave continues in third. Another half a dozen lengths back to Boca Grand. Around the far turn, Lady Joanne making a move for the lead now, and right there she's got it. 3 furlongs out, it's Lady Joanne, a narrow lead, but Octave is moving right with her. Nothing left for Bold Assurance now, and Boca Grand is starting to commence her rally just outside the quarter pole. She's only 3 lengths behind, and now the field turns for home, and it's Octave on the outside. Octave has taken the lead. Octave in front. Lady Joanne tries to get back in it. She's a length behind now, and it's another 3 lengths back to Boca Grand third. 1 furlong to go here. Octave driving full out on that lead. A resilient Lady Joanne is going to battle her all the way. Boca Grand will be third. They're coming down to the finish, and it's Octave. Final try from Lady Joanne, but Octave was second to none today, winning it by a neck over Lady Joanne. Boca Grand third.
Octave finally got that elusive Grade 1 victory, and it wasn't all that easy. She got the job done at the expense of Lady Joanie, who I thought her name was pronounced Lady Joanne. We heard it called Lady Joanne, but her trainer, Carl Nasker, indicating that the filly is known as Lady Joanie. She ran a good effort to finish second. In fact, Calvin Burrell digging down gamely in his usual part of the racetrack, down on the rail, fighting back late, not quite able to get back into the in there with Octave finally getting that win. Boca Grande running in the third spot. The winner, Octave, who had chased home the likes of Rags to Riches last time out in the Kentucky Oaks, obviously getting a little bit of a break there. 3-year-old Grey Arone Filly, a daughter of Unbridled Song from Belle Nuit by Dr. Carter, was bred in Kentucky by Mr. and Mrs. Martin Wygod, owned by the Starlight Stable and Donald Lucarelli. Trained by Todd Pletcher and ridden to victory by John Velasquez, Octave covers the 9 furlongs at Belmont in 147 flat. We'll head right back down to Belmont Park now in the Grade 1 Suburban Handicap on Saturday afternoon. Older horses, $400,000, 9 furlongs, and unfortunately, without Invasor, the race had lost a little bit of star power, but it was still a very exciting renewal of the Suburban. Let's head back down to New York for the call.
And they're off. Fairbanks immediately in stride for that early lead, but He's an Old Salt is with there with on the inside, and Political Force. Corinthian has come out fourth. So they make their way toward the backstretch run, and Fairbanks has made the lead easily. Out there by three. He's an Old Salt will sit back second. Political Force comes through on his inside, and Corinthian on his outside is running fourth by three. At the back of the pack, Longshot Malibu Moonshine and the veteran Evening Attire. Down the back stretch run after a quarter and 24 and one-fifth seconds. Fairbanks leads, but no free ride now. They're coming after him. He's an Old Salt, moves alongside with 7 furlongs to go. Corinthian in the clear, right up there out of harm's way in third position, and Political Force is a well-settled fourth. Evening Attire and Malibu Moonshine. The half in 47 and two-fifth seconds. Legitimate fractions here. Fairbanks once again has a clear lead. Fairbanks has opened up now to lead a length and a half. He's an Old Salt, and Corinthian gets a little nudge there with 5 furlongs to go. So Corinthian is making a bid for the lead just as they enter the far turn. Political Force remains in fourth, followed by Evening Attire and Malibu Moonshine. Around the far turn. Fairbanks has led throughout, through three-quarters of a mile in 1:10 and three-fifths seconds. Testing fractions now. It's Fairbanks still in front. Corinthian on the outside. Now Corinthian full out. No real response yet. Political Force is coming through an opening toward the inside. Right next to him, he's an Old Salt. Fairbanks in full stride as the field turns for home. And Political Force takes out after him at the top of the stretch. And Political Force is in front. Political Force is the leader as they come down to the final furlong here. Fairbanks is running second. Malibu Moonshine on the outside. Nothing left for Corinthian. Evening Attire is coming up the rail. And it is Political Force coming down to the finish to win it for trainer Alan Jerkins, who won it way back in 1962. And he's done it again for the fourth time here with Political Force.
Political Force, a horse that has had a lot of problems, and not necessarily all physical problems. Alan Jerkins has struggled with this very talented colt throughout the course of his career. I remember him from early on in his career. He gave them problems at the starting gate, would get to the front and goof off a little bit. In fact, did that here in this Grade One race. Got to the lead, looked like he was trying to let Fairbanks back into the race as he began to drift outwards a little bit. Cornelio Velasquez kept him straight, a couple of spanks of the whip to keep him with his mind on his business to get the length and a quarter victory at 5-1. Over Fairbanks, the early pace setter. Deep closing action from Malibu Moonshine at 52-1 to round out the top three. Very disappointing in here. The favorite, Corinthian. Really no excuse. He was a little bit on the wide side. Did not break all that alertly, but was into contention fairly early. And part of a pace that, they started out slow, 24.29, as is often the case in that mile and a quarter where they start on the turn, but they picked it up to a 110.69 for the 6 furlongs. He was involved in it right there while racing a little bit wide. That may have cost him, but Corinthian faded rather dramatically to finish 6th and last in this Grade One. Political Force, a grayer roan son of Unbridled Song from Glitter Woman by Glitter Man, was bred in Kentucky by Joseph Allen and is owned by the breeder. Trained by Alan Jerkins, who picked up his 4th victory in the Grade 1 Suburban Handicap, his first having come in 1962 when his Beau Purple upset Kelso, the great Kelso, in the Suburban that year. Obviously, he has been doing this for a long, long time and is one of the greats in the game, Political Force, earning him his 4th victory in this event under Cornelio Velasquez in a final time of 2:02. Pair of 2-year-old races on the docket for Sunday afternoon, beginning with the $100,000 Astoria for 2-year-old fillies. Let's head back to New York and the call of the Astoria.
And they're off. Glacken's Gal broke well at the rail. My Mammy on the outside. And Pure and Simple in between those two. 3 of them across the track for the early lead. They've opened up 3 lengths on the favorite, Dubbit, who's in 4th. Another 5 back to Halcyon, and Bridal Song is the trailer in 6th. Glacken's Gal at the rail now takes the lead by a neck. Pure and Simple running in 2nd. My Mammy on the outside in 3rd. Dubbit is now a close-up 4th, just 2.5 lengths from the lead. The first quarter went in 21 4/5 seconds. It's Glacken's Gal on the inside. My Mammy now moving into 2nd. Dubbit will look for racing room down on the inside. Pure and Simple is dropped back. Then Halcyon and Bridal Song. They're in the stretch. It's Glacken's Gal's short lead. Dubbett driving on the inside. My Mammy now in third. Glacken's Gal trying to hold off Dubbett with a 16th to the finish. It's Glacken's Gal now getting away to lead by two. Dubbett is second. Glacken's Gal wins the Astoria. Dubbett second. My Mammy was third.
A lot of shippers in here, as we haven't seen all that many two-year-old fillies in New York thus far, but Glacken's Gal, who broke her maiden right here at Belmont Park, got to the lead early and never looked back, kicking clear by two over Dubit, who made a nice bid, a little bit of a tight quarters there. There was some question as to whether or not there might be a steward's inquiry. Dubit under Garrett Gomez, who tried to shoot the rail. Glacken's Gal never really moved out and gave her the space that she needed. She tried to re-rally on the outside without success. My Mammy, while chasing the pace wide, finished third. Glacken's Gal, a bay filly, a daughter of Smoke Glacken from Lady Diplomat by Silver Deputy, was bred in New York by Peter Karchus and Michael Rankowitz, owned by the Let's Go Stable and trained by Todd Pletcher, ridden to victory by John Velasquez. Glacken's Gal covers the 5.5 furlongs at Belmont in 103 and 4. Next up, the ungraded $100,000 Tremont for two-year-old colts and geldings. Let's head back down to New York and the call of the Tremont.
And they're off. Ready's Image, there goes Nordic Wind. Nordic Wind up to grab the lead. Ready's Image in second, 28 Hours in third. Is He Speaking on the outside in fourth. A break of three to Fast Talking in fifth. Then Fort Drum in sixth. Lantana Mob is seventh. And Holidays trails the field at eighth as they move around the turn. Nordic Wind on the inside leads by a head. Ready's Image on the outside in second. The quarter in 21 and 4/5 seconds. Is He Speaking is 2 lengths off the lead, and the leader is now Ready's Image. Ready's Image is taken over from Nordic Wind. On the outside is Is He Speaking. Farther back, Lantana Mob, Fort Drum, and 28 Hours. They're in the stretch with Ready's Image in front by three. Is He Speaking second. Farther back, it's Lantana Mob and 28 Hours. And Ready's Image pouring it on here in the stretch, now leading by six. Is He Speaking second. Ready's Image, Todd Pletcher, John Velasquez. They take both of the two-year-old stakes today. They win the Tremont here by 7 lengths. Ready's Image the winner. Then Is He Speaking, 28 Hours, and Lantana Mob.
Ready's Image, Todd Pletcher sweeping the two-year-old races on Sunday afternoon. Ready's Image sitting a perfect trip right there, showing good speed out of the gate and never looking back from the top of the stretch. All of a sudden, at the blink of an eye, it opened up about a 5-length margin. I'm not even sure how he did it. He just suddenly just stretched his stride, didn't appear to suddenly increase, but he was absolutely impressive, drawing through the lane by almost six over Is He Speaking, who rallied a 25-1 to finish second with 28 Hours. Back in the third spot. Ready's Image, a dark bay or brown son of More Than Ready from Clever Phrase by Clever Trick, was bred in Maryland by Dark Hollow Farm and owned by James Scatorcio, trained by Todd Fletcher and ridden to victory by John Velasquez. Ready's Image covers the 5.5 at Belmont in 102 and 4. That'll finish up a very full program of racing. We've got a lot more racing for you next week's edition of Horses and Courses. We got a week's worth of stakes racing action. Obviously, we've got a midweek stake. A lot going on next weekend as well. We hope you'll be able to join us for next week's edition of Horses and Courses. Thanks for joining us this week. See you back here next time.